Hello, my lovely yin participants. Welcome to our class. My name is Tammy. Sliding back to our mats here. We are focusing on our sacral chakra. So we have our root chakra starting from the base, and so our pelvic floor, and then we lift up to our sacral chakra, which is just below our navel. And below our navel, and we are thinking about the different parts of this part of our body. So it is associated with the water element. So focusing on that, let's come into our first pose, which is easy pose. So crossing one leg in front of the other. You may sit on a chair, remove the fleshy part from your bottom. You may turn your palms up towards the sky. Close your eyes. Let's take a moment here in easy pose. Now notice below your navel, your sacral chakra. Breathing, inhaling, and exhaling. With our yin yoga, our breath is the ujjayi breath, but it is not as strong. So still hearing your breath, not as forceful. We still open up through the body with our inhale breath. The exhale breath is longer than the inhale breath to help us to release a little bit deeper as we hold the poses for a longer period of time. And we open up our eyes, take one hand down, then the other hand down. We're going to switch how we've crossed our legs here in front. And we hold easy pose again. This time you may place one hand onto your center of your body here, so into the chest, and then you may place one onto your sacral chakra. So just below your belly button here, and we can breathe into that area. Now our sacral chakra, if it may be blocked, it could be preventing our creative energies from flowing. And this time of the year in November, it's a little bit duller. You may not feel as much energy. So removing those blockages, helping us to improve our energy. So fatigue, creativity, we want to improve. You may also feel detached or emotionally numb, if this sacral chakra is blocked. Now, how may it become unblocked, or how may it be blocked? We may not be spending enough time playing, being creative. So we're really bringing attention to the seat area to help us with our energy flow, creativity, Now again, it is associated with water, being near water. It does help. A lake, a river, taking a bath, taking a shower. Now coming out of easy pose, we're going to release our hands down towards the side and coming just to the side of our body, we'll lie down onto our back and making our way into banana pose, banana asana. So we're lying on our back, knees bent here, take one leg and then the other leg down. We're making our banana shape by first walking our feet towards the left corner of the mat. And now walking our upper body towards the left corner of the mat. Now, if you notice that the right hip is really lifting up off the floor, just coming out of that banana shape a little bit, just where you find, yeah, I have my banana shape and I'm able to just let my body settle in this pose. You may take your hands, arms overhead, and you can just open up through the arms. You may hold onto your hands or the opposite elbows. Now, a bigger opening through our side of the body would be crossing your right ankle over top of the left ankle. So we hold our banana shape, finding that opening all through the right side of our body. To your IT band, between our rib cage, so the intercostals. And I'd like you just to breathe. Breathing into the lower part of our belly. Into our chest, opening. You may close your eyes, being present still, aware of how you are feeling in your physical body. Noticing your breath, how you're breathing. Are we able to release a little bit deeper in this pose with our exhale breath? out of our banana shape, the opposite way, and crossing your ankles, releasing your arms back down towards the side of the body, taking your upper body back towards the center, and then the legs as the last part. Making our way over to the other side. So now walking your feet, legs over to the other side. Keeping your pelvis down towards the ground, helping it just to release down. We walk our upper body over to the right side. Now notice that you're still long on both sides of the waist. You may take your arms overhead. You could hold on to the hands or opposite elbows, or just keeping your arms wide overhead. You may also cross your left ankle over top of the right. Here we again breathe into our belly, our chest, noticing opening into the lower part of your belly. We stretch into our IT band, running all along the side of our leg, and then again into the rib cage, your intercostals. You may close your eyes, but continue to notice your breath. Notice the opening with the inhale breath, the exhale breath, release, and the exhale breath. It is longer than the inhale breath. You may count it out. You may inhale for 4 counts, exhale for 6 counts. As you continue to practice your breath, you may be starting to inhale for 6 counts and exhaling for 8 counts. Continuing to increase the inhale, continuing to increase the exhale. And we make our way out of Banana Asana on this side. We release our arms and cross your ankles. Continue to release your arms back down towards the side. Take your upper body back towards the center and legs coming back. Now noticing your lower back, we're going to bend one knee. And then the other knee. Just do a little shift here. Take one knee in towards the chest and the other knee in towards the chest, and we hold. You can hold underneath of your knees into the knee pits. Just let your hands be squished here. Let your lower back settle in towards the ground. Drawing your thighs down in towards the lower body. So drawing those thighs down, and breathe into your thighs. Taking one foot, then the other foot down towards the ground. Taking your feet wider than the shoulders, we windshield wiper our knees side to side. Now take your arms out to the side here into line with your shoulders, and then turn your knees one way, and then turn your knees the other way. Now you may also turn your head the opposite way of the knees as you do that. And coming back to the center, keep one foot in, the other foot in towards the center. Our next pose is stirrup or happy baby. Take one knee in towards the chest, other knee in towards the chest. And we turn our knees out towards the armpits. Here you can hold and you just let your legs dangle and hold underneath of the knee pit. So you could be here, or you're gonna bring your legs up. Hold onto the ankles or the outside edges of your feet. And we open up through our knees. Here we're opening up through our pelvis, our groin. Again, turn your attention to your breath, breathing into the lower part of your belly. Thinking of the different organs that we have below our navel, again, association with the water element. Helping to stimulate those lower organs. Come out of stirrup just for a moment here by doing a roll side to side. And now this is definitely the fun. Roll side to side. So here's our playfulness, getting our playfulness in, and then come back to the center and then just hold again and then just open up through the lower part of your body. Knees coming down and breathe. Make yourself smile. Stirrup pose. We take the knees back towards the center. Now we take one foot down to the ground and then we float the other foot down towards the ground. We have a flowing bridge first and then we'll have a supported bridge. So placing your hands just by the side of the body, always looking up towards the sky. See if you can touch your heels with your fingertips. Now we look up, and a flowing bridge, we draw our pelvis up towards the sky, and then we draw down. We draw up, and we draw down. You may place your hands onto your hip bones, and we lift, and then down. We draw the sacrum up, and then we draw it down. One more time, we draw the sacrum up, and then we draw down. Okay, so we move from here with the flowing bridge to a supported bridge. Now you may use pillows, you could use a block, and I'm gonna show you with a block that you can take your block. It could be on the middle height here for your block. And so when you come into this bridge, we're not looking around, so just sliding, could be the pillow, it could be your block underneath of your sacrum, placing it where it's comfortable for yourself. And then you come into your shoulder bridge, and then we have that support, and we're opening up through the lower part of our belly into the sacral chakra. You can, of course, use pillows or that prop. It's sometimes nice to place your hands onto your belly, and you feel the rise and fall, or just the sides of the body. We have two more cycles of breath. Coming out slowly, always slowly out of our poses. So we're removing our prop, just taking them to the side. We let our pelvis rest down towards the ground. We can take one knee and then the other knee in towards the chest, and we hold here. You can rock side to side. And hold center. Take one foot down and then the other foot down. Take your right arm overhead. Now you can roll over to your right side to fetal. We take a moment here and then make our way back up. And we'll make our way into a seated pose. Take your legs forward and then we'll come into butterfly. Now with butterfly, we will use our pillows underneath of the knees. Taking your feet together, bottom of your feet together, and we have our pillows underneath of our knees. So with helping to remove any blockages that we may have into our sacral chakra, it's going to again help with creativity, increase awareness, remove fatigue. Now you can be here in a butterfly, you can be upright and you can just hold, or you can take an inhale breath, lift up, and then exhale breath, coming forward and fold. We let ourselves hang here. Let your head release. You may bring your arms forward. We hold. Again, turn towards your breath. The inhale, feeling it in, opening up through the belly, so into the lower part of the belly. Still opening up through our chest. Feeling your breath coming into the back of the body, the sides of the body. We think about rejuvenation, releasing. So some of the lower organs here, focusing on bladder, kidneys, our reproductive organs, having them be able to be healthy. Again, let your head release a little bit more. Let your exhale breath guide you. You may let your forehead rest by bringing your elbows down and then letting your forehead rest onto your hands. Use a pillow, let the forehead rest.
coming out of butterfly. Coming up slow.
You can take your hands behind. Take your legs forward. You can give them a little shake out. You may also windshield wiper your knees from side to side. It's going to remove my props here over to the side. And then you can do that with me. So taking your feet wider than the hips and then windshield wiper knees side to side. We now make our way into caterpillar. So we have caterpillar with our legs going straight ahead. Now remove the fleshy part from your bottom. You can bring your pillows back on top of your legs here and then lift up and then over top and then let the forehead rest. Now, if you find that your hamstrings are tight, which they, you know, our hamstrings, they are definitely something that we always are working on. You can roll up your mat. So sitting on a higher surface, you could even sit on a pillow, and then that's going to help because your hips will be higher than your knees and you sit on the edge of the pillow here. So it's comfortable for you. And then you can lift up and over. So that might work for you too. So just finding what's going to work for you. And setting yourself up because you do have time. You could stack pillows up and then just coming over and let the forehead rest. You could also have your elbows down. Let the forehead rest into your hands, your palms. Now you may be doing this without me even saying something, but breathing into the lower part of your belly, breathing into the belly, but really noticing that opening up. Now, sometimes for me, I do notice when I do have blockages in my sacral chakra, because I'm definitely not as creative, I feel that I have this block and I'm not sure what I should be doing, because I do plan a lot of things that do need me to be creative. And so I find, oh, I'm not really sure. So hopefully that doing this for myself too, of course, is going to help. And fatigue, we definitely are always fighting fatigue, always being so busy. So hopefully helping too with our fatigue.
out of caterpillar. We come up a little bit at a time here with our upper body. Taking your props to the side. And now we make our way over to child's pose. Just a soft bend through our knees. And coming to child's pose, you can have your knees pointing straight ahead. You can have your knees to the side. You could be on the side of your body and you can just be curled like this, that the knees are tucked in. You could also be on your back and tucking your knees into the chest for a cradle. So coming into what you would like to do. Your arms could be forward if you're in child's pose, could be by the side of the body. You do a little shift here through the body and then let yourself settle. Seeing if you're able to let the forehead rest. Let your pelvis release into the ground. We find our balance. Natural flow. Thinking of the water element, the flow. You may be picturing a river, a lake. You could be thinking about a nice bath. Out of child's pose, we make our way up And coming over to the side of the body and into half dragon, or I mean, not half dragonfly, but come into dragonfly. So with dragonfly, we will need props again. And I'm going to use my bolster here. So you would could use pillows that you would just place them in front like I am here. So sitting up with your pillows just in towards the groin here into your inner thighs. And we sit up tall. And now you could also stack more pillows on top. So you're going to let the lower, your lower body rest, but letting your upper body rest too. And here you can let the forehead rest. So just setting yourself up, taking that time that you need, and then we release. Like a few more cycles of breath in dragonfly. Feeling the belly opening through your back, opening sides of the body, opening with the inhale. Coming out of dragonfly, we lift. Okay. And lots of work through our pelvis, our legs here. So just bending those knees slowly. And now if you have enough room, you can, of course, just set your props over to the side here and then just a little windshield wiper through our legs. And we release. We make our way down towards the ground again, and we come towards our back. We have our supine twist. Into cradle we go with one knee and then the other knee in towards the chest. And now we bring our legs up and over to the left side. Bring your arms in line with your shoulders. You could also bend through the elbows and then just hold that way too, turning your head the opposite way of the knees. Let your physical body enjoy this twist. Let your mind feel at ease. Bringing your head back towards the center. We take our legs back to the center. And now bring your legs up and over to the other side. So I'm gonna scooch over a bit. You can still see me doing it. And then we bring the legs over and arms in line with the shoulders. Again, you can bend through your elbows too. Turn your head the opposite way. Let your eyes release, may close them. Feel a natural flow of your breath, just like water. Of the supine twist, we take our head back towards the center and bringing the legs back towards the center, we make our way into cradle. So the knees come into the chest and just let your knees sink down in towards the chest. Compression into the lower part of our belly again. And coming out of cradle, we are going to come into shavasana. So shavasana, you may lie on your back, your knees may be bent, be on the side of your body, you could be upright, you could have pillows underneath of your knees if you're lying on your back, or just one pillow, wherever it's going to be comfortable for you. You can place something onto your eyelids here. So I should say eyes, with the eyes closed. If you have an iPad, you can place that on. Also notice temperature in the space that you are practicing. Would you like to place a blanket on your body? In Shavasana. Our eye sockets feel heavy. We let our physical body release, let go. We feel calm, peaceful, balanced, in harmony. I will call you back when it is time. slowly starting to come back. We notice our breath. Noticing sensations running through your body. You wiggle your toes and fingers now. Maybe a shift through the body. If you're lying on your back, you can bend your right knee, left knee. Take your arm overhead and roll over to your right side to fetal. We take a moment and then make our way up to a seated pose. Placing your hands to your heart center. Close your eyes. Feeling the harmony, feeling the natural flow of your breath, feeling lighter. And we open up our eyes. Thank you very much for sharing your practice with me. Namaste.